Good morning children, welcome to the another class of botany. In today's class we are going to study about chromosomal mutation. So in the previous class we studied about the change in a gene or in a gene base pair, then it is called as gene mutation or a point mutation. If this alteration is taking place in a structure or in the number of chromosomes, okay, then it is called as chromosomal mutation or chromosomal aberration. So that is what given here, the definition you can mark it. The genome can be modified. Genome means the total number of gene found in an organism. Okay, so the genome can be modified on a larger scale by altering the chromosome structure or by changing the number of chromosome in a cell. These large scale variations, they are termed as chromosomal mutation or chromosomal aberrations. So here, if we are changing the structure of the chromosome, okay, or changing the number of chromosome, okay, then it is called as chromosomal mutation or chromosomal aberration. Gene mutation are changes that take place within a gene, whereas chromosomal mutation are the changes to a chromosome region consisting of many genes. So here, gene mutation is related to only one gene, okay. So change is taking place in one gene or in one gene base pair, then we call it as gene mutation or point mutation. Whereas here what is happening, many genes are involved here. Okay, the change is taking place in a particular segment of the chromosome. So in that particular segment of chromosome, there are numerous genes. So many genes are affected. Then it is called as chromosomal mutation. Okay, so it can be detected by microscopic examination, genetic analysis, or both. In contrast, gene mutation are never detectable microscopically. So here, this chromosomal mutation can be seen by the microscopic examination, by observing under the microscope, or by genetic analysis. Chromosomal mutation are divided into two groups: change in the chromosome number and change in the chromosome structure. So here we have studied, chromosomal mutation means a segment of the chromosome is changing. As a result, the structure is changing or the number of chromosomes are changing there. Then we call it as the chromosomal mutation. So here, based on this, they are classified into two types: change in the chromosome number, and second is change in the chromosome structure. So first let's study. And today we are going to study only about change in the chromosome number. Each cell of living organism possesses fixed number of chromosomes. As we know, all the organism has a fixed number of chromosomes. It varies in different species, even though some of the plants and animals are having identical number of chromosomes, they will not be similar in character. As we know, each organism, they have a fixed number of chromosomes. Okay, now here, in some species the chromosome number, in some plants or animals, the number of chromosomes may be similar, but these organisms, they will not be similar in character. Hence, the number of chromosomes will not differentiate the character of species from one another, but the nature of hereditary material, gene in the chromosome, that determines the character of the species. So here, as we have studied, there are some species of plants and animals which have the same number of chromosomes. So this doesn't mean that these organisms will have the same character. So the character of the organism is determined by the genes present in that chromosomes. Okay. So sometimes the chromosome number or somatic cells are changed due to the addition or elimination of individual chromosome or basic set of chromosome. So here, the chromosome number in the body cells or in the somatic cells, they can be changed by addition or removal of an individual chromosome. One chromosome is getting added up or it is getting removed. Or it may be a haploid set of chromosome. Basic set means, as we know, in a somatic cells we have the diploid number of chromosomes. So in that, half a set of chromosome, that is the haploid set, can be added up or that can be removed. So change in the chromosome number can be either by the addition or removal of one chromosome or a haploid set of chromosome. This haploid set is called the basic set of chromosome. For example, if we say human being, they have 46 chromosome. This 23, it is the haploid number, and this 23 is said to be the basic set. Okay, so this condition is known as numerical chromosomal aberration, or it is also called as ploidy. So here, what is ploidy? The chromosome number of somatic cells are changed due to the addition or elimination of a single chromosome or a basic set of chromosome. This condition is known as numerical chromosomal aberration, or it is also called as ploidy. So there are two types of ploidy. So two types of ploidy we have studying under this. The ploidy involving individual chromosomes within a diploid set. So that is addition or removal of one chromosome, okay, is called as aneuploidy. So as we have studied ploidy, there are two types. So it can be based on the change in the addition or removal of one chromosome or a basic set of chromosome. If one chromosome is added or deleted, okay, then it is called as aneuploidy. And ploidy involving entire set of chromosomes, that is one haploid set is getting added up or deleted, then it is called as euploidy. So here till now we have studied when there is a change in a chromosomal segment, okay, then it is called as, and that is in the number or in the shape structure, then we call it as chromosomal mutation or chromosomal aberration, we call it as. Okay, next we have studied this is brought about in two ways. Okay, so here either one chromosome is getting added up or removed, or a basic set of chromosome is getting added up or removed. If one chromosome is getting added or removed, then we call it as aneuploidy. If a basic set of chromosome is getting added or deleted, then we call it as euploidy. So basic set, we are already told you, it is the haploid number of chromosomes. Okay, so first let's study about the aneuploidy. It is a condition in which diploid number is altered either by addition or deletion of one or more chromosomes. So you can mark the definition for aneuploidy. It's a condition in which diploid number, so as you studied in somatic cells, we have diploid number of chromosomes. So this diploid number is represented by 2n. Okay, so this 2n number of chromosome is altered by addition or deletion of one or more chromosome. So here you can say 2n plus or minus 1 or 2n plus or minus 2. Okay. So organisms showing aneuploidy, they are called as aneuploids or heteroploids. So aneuploidy, we have studied the diploid number of chromosome is altered either by addition or deletion of one or more chromosomes. So here you can see in that types of ploidy, the flowchart is given here, ploidy. So here in this ploidy, we have studied ploidy is of two types, aneuploidy or it is euploidy. Aneuploidy, we have studied, is what change in the addition or deletion of one or two chromosome brings about the change in the diploid number, then it is called as aneuploidy. Euploidy, we have studied basic sets of the chromosomes are getting added or removed. So here in that, first we are studying about the aneuploidy. In aneuploidy, there are two types are there, hyperploidy and hypoploidy. Hyperploidy, hyper means something too much, something over than the normal, excess than the normal. So here that we have studied, hyperploidy is what? Trisomy, double trisomy, tetrasomy, double tetrasomy, pentasomy. So here trisomy, to the diploid number 2n, one chromosome is getting added up, then we call it as trisomy. Double trisomy means two individual chromosomes are getting added up, 2n plus 1 plus 1. Okay, then it is called as double trisomy. Tetrasomy means 2N plus 2. Okay, two chromosomes are getting added up. Double tetrasomy means two chromosomes are getting, two homologous chromosomes are getting added up. 2N plus 2 plus 2. Next is pentasomy is what? Three individual chromosomes are getting added up to the diploid number of chromosomes. 2N plus 3. Okay, next is what? The hypoploidy. Hypoploidy is what? When the chromosome number is reduced by one or two chromosomes, then we call it as hypoploidy. Hypo means less than the normal. Monosomy. Monosomy. Diploid number minus 1. Then we call it as monosomy. Double monosomy, 2N minus 1 minus 1. Nullisomy, 2N minus 2. Okay. Double nullisomy, 2N minus 2 minus 2. So here we will understand here. So already we have studied the organisms which show the aneuploidy. They are called as aneuploids or heteroploids. They are of two types, hyperploidy and hypoploidy. As we know, ploidy, they are of two types, aneuploidy and euploidy. Aneuploidy is what we have studied, alteration in the diploid number of chromosomes by addition or deletion. If addition of the chromosome is taking place to the diploid number, we call it as hyperploidy. If the deletion is taking place, we call it as hypoploidy. Okay. So, hyperploidy and hypoploidy are the two types of aneuploidy. Next, we are going to study hyperploidy. Addition of one or more chromosome to the diploid set is called as hyperploidy. Diploid set of chromosome is represented as disomy, that is 2N. Hyperploidy can be divided into three types. They are as follows. Trisomy, first one, trisomy. So, addition of a single chromosome to the diploid set is called as simple trisomy. So, diploid set is 2N. To that, a single chromosome is getting added up. So, 2N plus 1. This condition is called as simple trisomy. Trisomics were reported by Blaxley in Datura Stramonium. But later, it was reported in Nicotiana Pisum and Oinothera. Sometimes, addition of two individual chromosomes from different chromosomal pairs to normal diploid sets are called as double trisomy. So, here what we have studied, if two individual chromosomes from different chromosomal pairs, okay, they are added to the diploid set, then it is called as double trisomy, 2N plus 1 plus 1. Okay. Next is the next type of hyperploidy is tetrasomy. Addition of a pair or two individual pair of chromosomes to diploid set, they are called as tetrasomy. That is 2N plus 2. A chromosomal pair is getting added up. Then we call it as tetrasomy. And double tetrasomy is 2N plus 2 plus 2 respectively. All possible tetrasomy are available in the wheat. So underline there, tetrasomics you can find in the wheat varieties. Next, pentasomy. Addition of three individual chromosomes from different chromosomal pairs to normal diploid set, they are called as pentasomy. So, pentasomy is what? Addition of three individual chromosomes to the diploid. So, 2N plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, or simply written as 2N plus 3. Then this is called as pentasomy. So, here we have studied hyperploidy. They are of three types, trisomy, tetrasomy and pentasomy. Okay, trisomy is represented by 2N plus 1. Okay, next, double trisomy is represented by 2N plus 1. Okay, plus 1. Next, tetrasomy. Tetrasomy is what we have studied, to the diploid number 1 pair of chromosome is getting added up. So, 2N plus 2, that is simple tetrasomy. Double tetrasomy, 2N plus 2 plus 2. Next is pentasomy. Pentasomy is if three individual chromosomes are getting added up to the diploid number. So 2n plus 3, then it is called as pentasomy. Next, you are going to study about hypoploidy. Loss of one or more chromosome from the diploid set in the cell is called as hypoploidy. So removal of one or more chromosome, then it is called as hypo. Hypo means less. Okay, so it can be divided into two types. They are monosomy and nullisomy. Loss of a single chromosome from the diploid set, they are called as monosomy. That is loss of a single chromosome. 2n diploid set minus 1, then it is called as monosomy. However, loss of 2 individual or 3 individual chromosomes, they are called as double monosomy and triple monosomy respectively. So here, if from the diploid set 2 individual chromosomes are removed, then it is called as double monosomy. If 3 individual chromosomes they are removed, then it is called as triple monosomy. Nullisomy, loss of a pair of homologous chromosome, okay, or 2 pair of homologous chromosome from the diploid set, they are called as nullisomy or double nullisomy. So from the diploid set, if one pair of chromosome, that is 2n minus 2, okay, this is called as nullisomy. Suppose if 2 homologous pair of chromosomes are removed, 2n minus 2 minus 2, then it is called as double nullisomy. Selfing of monosomic plants produce nullisomics. They are usually lethal. Okay, so monosomics are usually, they are the lethals. So here you can see the types of aneuploidy in the figure 3.11. So diploid number of chromosomes present in an organism, it is represented by disomy, normal stage that is. Monosomy is from the diploid 2n, one chromosome is lost, 2n minus 1. So that is monosomy. Next, double monosomy, 2n minus 1 minus 1. So here from the diploid number of chromosomes, 2 individual chromosomes are lost, then we call it as double monosomy. Next is the nullisomy, that is from the diploid set of chromosome, 2 pair of chromosomes are lost. Okay, 1 pair of chromosomes are lost, that is 2 chromosomes, homologous chromosomes, they are lost. Then this is called as nullisomy, represented by 2n minus 2. Next, trisomy we have studied. Trisomy is what? It is a hyperploidy type, that is 2n to the diploid number of chromosome, one individual chromosome is getting added up, then we call it as trisomy, 2n plus 1. Next is double trisomy, that is to the diploid number of chromosome, 2 individual chromosomes are getting added up, 2n plus 1 plus 1. Okay, that is double trisomy. Tetrasomy, to an individual chromosome, a pair of chromosomes are getting, a homologous chromosomes are getting added up, 2n plus 2, then it is called as tetrasomy. Next, pentasomy, to a diploid number of chromosome, 3 individual chromosomes are getting added up, then it is called as pentasomy. So hope you have understood about the types of aneuploidy. So aneuploidy already we have studied. What is an aneuploidy? If there is the alteration in the number of chromosome, if only one or more chromosomes they are getting added or removed, then we call it as aneuploidy. Okay, next type of ploidy we are going to study here, it is euploidy. So what is this euploidy? It's a condition where the organism possesses one or more basic set of chromosome. If an organism possesses one or more basic set, already I told you, basic set means the haploid number of chromosome of an organism, then it is called as the basic set. So euploidy is a condition where the organism possesses one or more basic sets of chromosome. Euploidy is classified as monoploidy, diploidy and polyploidy. The condition where an organism or somatic cell has two sets of chromosomes, they are called the diploid, as we know. Somatic cells, they contain diploid number of chromosomes, 2n number of chromosomes. Half the number of somatic chromosomes, they are referred as gametic chromosome number, and they are called the haploid. So as we know, in the gametes we have only the haploid number of chromosomes. Okay, if the condition where an organism or somatic cell has one set of chromosome, they are called so the condition where the organism or somatic cell has two sets of chromosomes, they are called the diploid. Number of somatic chromosomes, okay, half what that is the somatic cells, they contain diploid number of chromosomes, that is found in the gamete, so that is called as the gametic chromosomes, and they are called as the haploid. It should be noted that is haploid N is different from a monoploidy X. For example, the common wheat plant is a polyploidy, okay, that is it is a hexaploidy. 2N is equal to 6X is equal to 72 chromosomes. Its haploid number N is 36, but its monoploidy X is 12. Therefore, okay, children, 72 is the diploid number of chromosomes, but the monoploidy number, haploid number of chromosome is found to be 36, but monoploidy number is what? It is 12. Therefore, the haploid and diploid condition can regularly came regularly one after another, and the same number of chromosomes is maintained from generation to generation, as we know, for the continuity of the species. So somatic cells, they have the diploid number of chromosomes. Gametes, they have the haploid number of chromosomes. Because of this haploid number of chromosomes only, in the next generation also the same species, they have the same number of chromosomes. Okay, but monoploidy condition occurs when an organism is under polyploidy condition. In a true organism is under polyploidy condition, in a true diploid, both the monoploid and the haploid condition chromosome number are same. Okay, in a diploid condition, what will happen? The monoploid numbers and the haploid chromosome numbers, they will be remaining the same. Thus, a monoploid can be a haploid, but all haploids cannot be a monoploids. So, already we have studied here an example. If a diploid number of chromosome is 72, then haploid number is 36, but monoploid number is 12. So, here, but in some species, that this diploid number, that is the haploid number of chromosomes and the monoploid numbers can be the same. Okay, so that is why it is said that monoploid can be haploid, but all haploids, they are not the monoploids. Okay, so polyploidy. Polyploidy is a condition where an organism possesses more than two basic sets of chromosomes. Okay, so here polyploidy is a condition where an organism possesses more than two basic sets of chromosomes. When 3, 4, 5, or 6 sets of chromosomes, they are called as triploidy, tetraploidy, pentaploidy, and hexaploidy respectively. Generally, polyploidy is very common in plants but rarer in animals. Okay, an increase in the number of chromosomes, an increase in the number of chromosome sets has been an important factor in the origin of new plant species, but higher ploidy level leads to death. Okay, so here increase in the number of chromosomes is useful in the plants, but it causes the more the number of ploidy, it causes the death of an organism. Polyploidy is of two types. They are autopolyploidy and allopolyploidy. So autopolyploidy, an organism which possesses more than two haploid set of chromosomes derived from within the species, it is called as autopolyploidy. So here, if the chromosome number, the diploid number of chromosome is added up in the contains the more number of chromosomes than the diploid number of chromosomes, okay, then this basic set which is added to this diploid number, it is of the same species, then it is called as autopolyploidy. Okay, that is, in the increase in the basic set of chromosomes, okay, within the same species, then it is called as autopolyploidy. If this increase in the basic set of chromosome is taking place between two different species, then it is called as allopolyploidy. Okay, so polyploidy, they are of two types. Okay, autopolyploidy and allopolyploidy. Autopolyploidy is what? The addition of the chromosome is addition of basic set of chromosome is taking place within a same species. Okay, then it is called as autopolyploidy. And allopolyploidy is what? When the addition of the basic set of chromosomes to the diploid number is from two different species, then it is called as allopolyploidy. Autopolyploidy. An organism which possesses more than two haploid set of chromosomes and they are derived within the same species, it is called as autopolyploidy. They are divided into two types, autotriploids and autotetraploids. Now, autotriploids have three sets of its own genomes. They can be produced artificially by crossing between autotetraploid and diploid species. They are highly sterile due to defective gamete formation. So here what is happening to the diploid number of chromosome? One basic set is getting added up. So this condition can be obtained by crossing an autotetraploid. Okay, autotetraploid will get a 2n number of chromosome and a diploid species will get an n number of chromosome. So 2n into n. So we will be getting what? 3n. Okay. So here that is autotriploids we are getting. So in this condition, okay, they are mostly sterile. Autotriploids, they are sterile. Example, the cultivated banana are usually triploids and are seedless, having larger fruits than the diploids. So here you can see autotriploids. The advantage of some is that is your the banana plant, we have the they are the triploids. Okay, and they are seedless, the size of the fruit is larger than the diploids. Now triploid sugar beets have higher sugar content than diploids and are resistant to molds. Common dhub grass, that is Cynodon dactylon, is a natural autotriploid. Seedless watermelon, apple, sugar beet, tomato, banana are man-made autotriploids. So here we have studied what are autotriploids. If one basic set of chromosome is added to the diploid number, okay, then it is called as autotriploid. So this basic set is of the same species, then we call it as autotriploids. So here we have studied how we can obtain the autotriploids, that is by crossing an autotetraploid with the diploid. So autotetraploid will have 2n number of chromosomes, okay, and the diploid, that is in the gamete, we have 2n number of chromosomes, and in the diploid, we in the gamete, we will have the n number of chromosomes. So when we cross this, we will get 3n conditions and autotriploids. So here we have studied example, the in banana plants, they are triploids and they have the larger size of banana fruits and they are seedless. Next we have studied about the example of dhub grass. Okay, they are also autotriploids. Next we have studied sugar beet, they are also the higher content in them is because of this autotriploid and they are resistant to the molds. Next, you are going to study about autotetraploids. Autotetraploids have four copies of its own genome. They may be induced by doubling the chromosome of a diploid species. Example, rye grapes, alfalfa, groundnut, potato, and coffee. So here, autotetraploids, they have the four copies of its own genome. That is, they have 4n number of chromosomes in their genome, then it is called as autotetraploids. So this is about the autopolyploidy. Autopolyploidy, you have studied when a basic set of chromosome is added up within the same species, then it is called as autopolyploidy. They are of two types, autotriploids and autotetraploids. Next we are going to study about allopolyploidy. An organism which possesses two or more basic sets of chromosomes derived from two different species, then it is called as allopolyploidy. So here basic number of chromosome is getting added up, but it is the basic set is from different species, then we call it as allopolyploidy. It can be developed by interspecific crosses. Interspecific means two different species are being crossed here, and fertility is restored by chromosome doubling with Golgi sign. So here the, as we have studied, autotriploids and it is on their steroid. Okay, so here this chromosome numbers is the fertility, they can be maintained by doubling the number of chromosome, and that method is called as the Golgi sign method. Golgi sign is an alkaloid which is used to double the number of chromosomes. Now, allopolyploids, they are formed between closely related species only. Okay, next here you can see the example, you can see a triticale. So here Triticum durum, this is the parent wheat variety. Durum is a wheat variety. Next is CKL cereal, that is the rye variety. Okay, Triticum durum, they are diploid number of chromosomes, they contain 28, 4x, the monoploid condition is 4x. Okay, next CKL cereal, 2n is equal to 14, and the monoploid condition 2x. So during the gamete formation, what is happening, half the number of chromosome. So n is equal to 14, that is 2x, and here n is equal to 7, so here it is x. Okay, so here in the F1, when the cross is done in the F1 generation, we will get diploid condition 2n. Next we will have the, that is equal to 3x, 2x and x, we will get the 3x, 14 and 7 will get 21. So in the F1 hybrid condition, we are getting what, 21 number of chromosomes. Okay, diploid condition consists of 21 chromosomes. So this 21 chromosomes, they are sterile condition. So here what is happening, this is treated with the Golgi sign. Okay, so here it is treated with the Golgi sign. As a result, what we are getting, the chromosome numbers, as we know, Golgi sign is an alkaloid which is used to double up the chromosome. So here what will happen, the monoploid is becoming a hexaploid, and the diploid number of chromosomes is getting doubled up and it become 42. Now this is what it is, a hexaploid condition. Okay, so here the species name is triticale. This triticale is the first man-made species. Okay, triticale is the first man-made species here. So here you can see the example for this. So here you can see my example 1, Raphano brassica. Okay, so here you can see Raphanus. Okay, that is the radish is crossed with the brassica. Okay, Raphanus diploid number 2n is equal to 18, brassica 2n is equal to 18. So here what you are getting, when they are crossed in the F1 generation, we are getting a sterile hybrid. So diploid number 2n is equal to 18. Okay, so fertile, it is amphidiploid. Okay, so Raphano brassica 2n is equal to 4x is equal to 36, that is treated with the Golgi sign, the chromosome number is getting double up. So Raphano brassica is this tetraploid which is having a 36 number of chromosomes. So example, Raphano brassica GD Karpichenko in 1927, a Russian geneticist crossed the radish Raphanus sativus, that is 2n is equal to 18, and cabbage brassica oleracea, that is also 2n is equal to 18. So two different plants, two producers, radish and cabbage, they were crossed and to produce in the F1 hybrid a sterile plant. When it was doubled, the chromosome of F1 hybrid, he got it fertile. He expected this plant to exhibit the root of radish and the leaves like cabbage, which would make the entire plant edible, but the case was vice versa, so he was greatly disappointed. Next is the example 2, is the triticale. So the successful first man-made cereal. So this is the first man-made cereal. It is an artificial cereal. Depending on the ploidy level, triticale can be derived into three main groups. Okay, they can be autotetraploids, hexaploids and octoploids. So tetraploids, when the cross is done between diploid wheat and rye. Hexaploids can be obtained when the cross is done between tetraploid wheat and triticum durum, okay, and rye. Next, octoploidy can be done, okay, that is cross between a hexaploid wheat, T astivum, triticum astivum, that is bread wheat and rye variety. So here it's an hexaploid is crossed with a diploid, so we'll get an octoploid. Hexaploidy triticale hybrid plant demonstrate characteristics of both macaroni wheat and rye. Okay, so here for example, they combine the high protein content of wheat with rice high content of amino acid lysine, which is low in wheat. So as we know, here wheat and rye variety was crossed. So here this wheat, they have a high protein content, and rye, they have a high amino acid content. So here these two are crossed. Okay, so here what we are getting in a triticale, we get a high protein content with a high amount of amino acid. So here what is colchicine is given, an alkaloid. It is extracted from the root and combs of colchicium autumn nail. When applied in low concentration, the growing tips of the plant, it will induce polyploidy. So in a small amount of colchicine when treated to the plant, it will causes the increase in the double causes the doubling of the chromosome, but it does not affect the source plant, that is, it does not cause any change in the colchicium autumn nail because of the presence of anticolchicine there. Next, you are going to study here the significance of ploidy. Many polyploids and more adaptable than diploids. So here these polyploids, they are high yielding and they can adapt to the various environmental conditions. Many ornamental plants are auto tetraploids and have larger flowers and longer flowering duration than diploids. Another advantage here it is, if the plants, they are auto tetraploids, the flowers they obtain, they are of larger size and they can, the long flowering duration, they can flower for a longer time. Auto polyploids usually have higher in fresh weight due to more water content. Another feature it is what they are, since they are larger in size, so they have fresh water weight content is more. Next, aneuploids are useful to determine the phenotypic effects of loss or gain of different chromosomes. So aneuploidy we have studied already. What is aneuploidy? One or two chromosomes are getting added up or removed from the diploid set of chromosomes. So here this aneuploidy, they help us to know the phenotypic effect or loss or gain of different chromosomes. Next, many angiosperms are allopolyploids and they play a role in the evolution of plants. So many flowering angiosperms means the flowering plants, they are allopolyploids. Allopolyploids here studied addition of a basic set of chromosome from a different species. Okay, so and they play, as a result what we get a new plant, new type of plants, or can lead to the evolution of new varieties of plants. So these are the significance of ploidy. So hope you have understood today what we have studied, that is the change in the chromosome number alone we have studied. That is, today we studied about the numerical chromosomal aberration, or we have studied about the ploidy. In the next class, we will be studying about the structural chromosomal aberration. Okay, hope children you have understood everything. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you, children.